sing with me. Song you know? Can you give us a good intro?
Thank you.
exactly the same. Jesus loves us. Sing with me loud like you mean it. Let's fill this church.
His son with most loving arms and
and said to us, that is what your God is like. What if we didn't know that? Your patron saint tells us about that part of Jesus and that part of God. In the Gospel of Luke, the themes of forgiveness run through strong from beginning to end, culminating on the cross. When Jesus says, as recorded only in the Gospel of Luke, do you remember? Forgive them, Father. Why? Forgive them because they don't know what they're doing. Think of the people given that grace, given that power, who have been able to offer forgiveness like that, and what it tells us about the loving forgiveness of God and how it changes the world. Think of the witness of the families of the Charleston Nine. Remember what they said to that poor, troubled boy who slaughtered their loved ones and their pastor, son? What that said to the world about who we're called to be as followers of Jesus and who our God is. Jesus also had, according to Luke, the most intimate relationship with God. He called him Father, as it's translated into the English, but it's not the word Father like Almighty Father and bow before his presence. It's like Daddy. Pops. How we refer to his God, and how when he taught us to pray, our Father, he wanted that image in our minds, that intimate, loving parent who is always more ready to receive us than we to go to him, always more ready to offer grace than we to ask for it. And that's what your patron saint of St. Luke's Church, wanted you to know. Now, I served a church for 18 years before I became bishop that had a patron saint name, also one of the big heroes of the New Testament, St. John the Baptist. And after, you know, a time, I began to realize that even though I had no idea why the founders of that church chose that particular saint's name, why they chose John the Baptist, every time I looked at John the Baptist, and every time I thought about my church, I thought, well, yeah, I get this. It's like his spirit, his charism, his very essence was somehow like a mantle over us, and it became a part of us. And likewise, I really have no idea why the founders of St. Luke's Parish, why those brave men and women decided to leave St. Mary's Chapel for the colored that was established by the wealthy white Episcopal churches on the other side of town with the help of the people who wanted a church there. But why some, led by your amazing leader, the Reverend Alexander Crummell, decided to come over here and to start for themselves their own church, and to be their own people, why they chose St. Luke. I don't know. But one thing I know, there's a power in that name, and there's a power in that mantle, and you have been in the presence of that spirit and that power every time you gather in Jesus' name. Because Luke's gifts are among you and part of you. There's power in that name. Power in his way of presenting Jesus to us, that you are entrusted with. So, I'm going to say one more thing about this, and that's about you and each one of you and your name and who you are. Because just like Luke gives us a glimpse into Jesus that only Luke can give, so each one of you live the way you live and the way you follow him is utterly unique. It's completely and uniquely your way of being in the world. And if we didn't have you, we would miss that. It wouldn't be here. And it's so important that you're here that you are who you are, who God has created you to be, and the way you walk as one of his followers. And so too, St. Luke's, in this day, the fact that you're here matters so much, which is why I will spend every day I am privileged to serve as your bishop, praying for you, doing everything I can to work and walk alongside you so that this church can become strong and powerful, a cathedral for all people, as your prayers say, because your witness matters. The theologian, the African-American theologian Kelly Brown Douglas, who's now the canon theologian also at Washington National Cathedral, she wrote a book recently called Stand Your Ground, Black Bodies and the Justice of God. And she said that her mother, every night before she and her siblings went to bed, sang that song that we all sang as we were beginning our time together, Jesus Loves Me. And she said her mother wanted them to know, without a shadow of a doubt, how much they were loved by Jesus and prized by God, because she knew that they would go out into a world that every day might try to tell them otherwise. And she wanted them not to ever doubt who they were. And likewise, she, as a mother now of a young African-American young man, she has told him every day of his life how prized he is by God and loved by Jesus, because there's just too many messages out there that would tell him, tell all of us, tell all of our young people otherwise. So you remember that, my friends of St. Luke's, that you are embodied with a message and a power of love, that through the grace of Jesus that flows through the church, flowed through the pen of St. Luke and flows through our lives, is the witness that allows us to say with confidence, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves you. Yes, Jesus even loves those we struggle mightily to love and who do not love us. And yes, Jesus loves us all as beloved children. So, my challenge to you is this week, pick up your Bibles with you when you're home and start reading from beginning to end the gospel that bears your patron saint's name. 22 chapters, not 24 chapters. If you sat down at noon, you'd be done by supper time. If you took it a chapter a day, you'd be done in a month, and I promise you, it will change you. It will soften your heart, it will inspire you, it will fill you with love and an understanding of Jesus' love for the world that will make your step lighter and your faith stronger and help you to be a vessel of that blessing in the world. And I'll do it with you. I'll do it right next to you. In fact, I'm doing it now because it's in the daily lectionary of our church right now. We're reading the gospel. I'm telling you, it makes me happy every time I do. So I encourage you, I invite you, in fact, I dare to exhort you as your bishop to do that for yourself and your loved ones. Pick up your Bible, read your patron saint, and remember how much Jesus loves you. Amen.
Amen.